Hey everyone, Board Game Brody here with Meeple Mountain. I have Cosmic Colonies here by Floodgate Games. It's a polyomino tile laying drafting game that is oh so good. Players will be competing to construct new buildings by using each unique worker that they get their hands on and gathering specific resources. Each round brings in new workers, giving players new opportunities and new talent to the team for the time being, because the workers that you use will also go work for the other players, and the workers that the other players use will come and work for you. Players all need to be creative in their planning and build the best city, as it's not easy to build the city on an asteroid, but it is possible. At the beginning of the game should be set up, and it should look something like this. Now this is the main board here that shows the price of each polyomino that you can buy and add it to your own personal asteroid, and depending on the player count, this board flips over to show either more spaces for the market or less spaces. Down here at the bottom of the board shows the resource locations. These are the available resources players choose from on their turn, and each round you'll be adding in more and more resources of each type. If we go back up to the market, you can see that the prices for each of these tiles matches one of the types of resources. After purchasing a tile, you'll be placing it on your player board. The first tile can be placed anywhere, but after that, each additional tile placed on your board needs to touch a tile that has already been placed. And the tile should be placed within the grid on your board, unless you have an added ability. Each player will start with a player board, each being a little bit different from each other, and each with two sides. One side when playing the advanced game, and the other side for the basic game. Either way that you play the game, you will get points at the end of the game for covering up the different type of terrain on your board. If you cover up all of a specific type of terrain, then you will score the most points allotted for that specific type of terrain. With covering up the red terrain giving you the most points, and covering up all the ice spots giving you less points. While placing your tiles, you need to decide which terrain to cover up to help you with these goals as well. In the basic game, the dirt squares don't really matter, so you will want to focus on covering up the other types of terrain, but you can cover up the dirt when needed. But in the advanced game, you will score additional points for not covering up the dirt. Anyways, let's reverse it back real quick. Each player will start with one of each type of resource, placing them in their warehouse. Players can only hold up to 9 resources at a time. Players will start the game with 4 worker cards that are randomly dealt out. Depending on the player count, you will use either more or less cards, with the extras being placed in the box to be used another time that you play the game. These 4 cards are kept secret from the other players. If you play the basic game, each worker has 1 ability. But in the advanced game, each worker will have 2 abilities, which depends if you play it during the day or during the night. Each round you'll play 2 cards, and in the advanced game, the first card is played in the day using its day ability, and the second card is played during the night using its night ability. But no matter which player you're playing the game, you'll be playing 2 cards per round. Each player will also have an objective card that should be kept secret. It lists 2 different types of tiles, and when used, will score them extra points. The game takes place over 8 rounds, with 2 phases in each round. The action phase is when players will simultaneously select one of their 4 worker cards, and simultaneously will reveal them all at the same time. After the reveal, players will perform their actions depending on the priority number shown on the top left of each chosen worker. Starting with the player who has the lowest number, players will choose to do 1 of 2 options. That player will either collect more resources of one type, with the card listing the limit of how many resources that worker can take. You will add those resources to your warehouse, not to exceed 9. Or you can choose to buy a tile and place it on your asteroid. Just remember, when you choose which of the two actions that you want to take, the worker you choose will possibly enhance your action. You will need to plan which worker to play to better match the action that you will be taking so your action can be more efficient. If playing the advanced game, this first card will be using the day action on the card. After each player has gone, each player will again choose another card from their hand of now three cards and play it. Again, if playing the advanced game, you'll be using the night action for this second worker. And as you can see, you almost need to have a plan for what day action and which night action you want from the four cards that is most likely formed at the beginning of each round. At the beginning of each round when you have the four cards to choose from. After each player plays two cards and does the two actions each, the action phase ends and the refresh phase begins. Resources will be added from the supply to the main board, one of each resource per player in the game without exceeding the limit of 5 in a 2-3 player game or 7 in a 4-5 player game. Any empty building slots are refilled with the matching tiles. The round marker is moved on the round track, and each player will then pass their two use cards to the left while also receiving two worker cards from their right. Also know this will be a little bit different in a two-player game. So this means that when choosing which workers that you want to use, you will knowingly pass them to your opponents to use as well. After 8 rounds, you will have played 16 workers, gained many resources to spend to buy tiles to place on your player board, hopefully covering the listed terrain types, to score additional points. Players will score 2 points for each tile that they placed on their board, matching the top tile on their objective card. Similarly, they will score 1 point for each tile shown on the bottom of their objective card. 15 points will be given to each complete set of the 5 main building tiles placed on each of the player's board, with each tile only being counted towards one set. Then players will score additional points depending on certain terrain types that are not covered by tiles, and players will visit this chart here on their player board to score the indicated points. For example, as you can see here, there are 3 of this ice terrain that was not covered on this board. So you will go over and look at this chart and you will see that 3 uncovered, you're going to score 2 points. You will do that for each of the 3 terrain types. The player with the highest score is the winner of the game. The game can be played under an hour, which is a huge plus for many who don't want to or who don't like the long games. The game has polyominoes, which a lot of people enjoy. I think the puzzly aspect of those tiles uses a section of your brain that satisfies you without ever hitting that frustration part. I will have to admit that I was surprised after my first game how much of my board I did not fill in, which left me a little bit disappointed as I wanted to fill in the entire board to score the most points. After playing it a couple more times, I found that first, depending on the player count, you will have different cards in each time that you play. Some of these cards will help you with the tile placement more than others, like the artist that adds a 1 square tile or the botanist that adds a 2 square tile on your board, but everyone is kind of semi-exposed to the same cards, and it's not going to be the same every time you play the game. I say semi-exposed because the game uses a drafting mechanic where whatever card you use, it will be sent to another player to use as well. So you can keep certain powerful cards in your hand so others can't use them. You can get rid of less powerful cards so it clogs up someone else's hand, giving you increased opportunities to play the perfect card for the perfect moment. Or you can just play the best card for your situation each time, knowing that it will also help other players most likely in the future. Now, going back to the desire to fill in the entire board, I found that if you filled in the entire board each time you play, the game really wouldn't be any fun. I mean, it would be too easy. So the fact that it's hard to fill in all the terrain squares makes the placement of your tiles even more important, as you will be forced to make choices how you best fill in your board. there is a little bit of resource management where you need to make sure that you have certain resources to build the tiles that you want, but the game is focused more on those cards, as it's fairly simple to collect some resources at some point, but it's harder to collect 4 or 5 resources that you want by using the perfect card to do so. When deciding on what card to play, which can be very simple at times as you only have 4 choices, but it can also be fairly tough to choose from, as timing can be huge in the game. Each card has a priority number, and after everyone flips over their cards at the same time, the lowest number gets to do their action first. If you have a high number card and that tile that you wanted to purchase is now gone, or the resources that you wanted to collect have dispersed, then you will need to figure something else out. I have felt like the priority number on the cards and how good the cards are don't really correspond all too well, as I feel like some low numbered cards are really powerful, but I also feel like some high number cards are powerful as well. Similarly, some high number cards are a little weak, as well as some low number cards. But all the card's abilities are relatively situational as well, where at times a card can be powerful for you and less powerful for another player. The game is a gateway weight game that is great for players who like strategy, but with simple rules and easy to play and get to the table. The game scales up with more strategy with the advanced cards that gives you more possible enhancements when taking an action and increasing the importance of planning and timing of playing certain cards. The game also has the same issue we see with a lot of games, which is the box is huge and there is a lot of empty room when everything is placed inside it. But this also might be on purpose, leaving room for future expansions, which I would approve of. So hurry and get your friends and your family gathered together to find a new home on the asteroid placed before you in Cosmic Colonies by Floodgate Games. Again, this is Board Game Brody. I hope you enjoyed this video. Stick around and check out some other board game reviews to see what you might want to get to the table.